Help me help
In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install and run Kali Linux on rooted Android phone, using Linux Deploy app. Using Kali Linux in Android, we can try the features of Kali Linux on Android, so let's get into it. Requirements as follows. ES File Explorer. Busybox. Linux Deploy. Termius. VNC Viewer. RAR. And a Kali Linux image file. Go to this website to download Kali Linux image file. You can run and install full or basic version of Kali Linux image. For now I'm going to use basic version of image file for this tutorial. After downloading the file, open the ES File Explorer. Go to download folder, and you will get a zip file, which you downloaded. Extract the zip file using RAR app. Wait for the extraction to complete. Extraction takes about 4 to 5 minutes, so I will skip the process. After extraction, you will get two files of Kali Linux. Rename the extracted folder to Kali. And move the Kali folder outside of the download folder. Close the app. Open Busybox app. It will install all basic commands of the Kali Linux for Android using Smart Install. Don't modify any settings inside the Busybox for the prevention of further problems. Close the Busybox app. Now open Linux Deploy app. Wait for the updation to complete. Select the download button below. Under containerization method, select chroot option. Select distribution to Kali Linux. Under Architecture, select ARMHF. Select Distribution Suite to Kali Rolling option. Select Installation Type to File option. Under the Installation Path option, remove the pre-existing path. Open ES File Explorer. Select the image file. Copy the full path of the extracted file of Kali Linux image. Paste the path which is copied. Under the file system, select X4 option. Change the password to change me. Select the initialization system option. Select the SSH server option. Select the graphical environment option. Now the selection process is complete. Select the three dots in the upper right corner. Select the configure option. Wait for the installation to complete, which takes around 4 to 5 minutes. If you have any problem during the installation process, feel free to comment, and I will help you to solve the problem. Start the container using Start option. Close the app. Now open Termius app. Select Hosts option. Press the plus sign and select New Host option. Type host name as localhost. Select SSH option. Type the port as 22 if it's not specified. The username should be same as it is in the Linux deploy app, which is Android. And also the password, which is change me. Select done. Click on host you created. It will ask for the confirmation of RSA key, which is a connection key. Press connect. It will open the terminal. Now type su. Type the password as 4, which is a default password for su. Now type BNC server. You will get output as localhost, session number, in which the session number starts from 1 and so on. Session number changes whenever you create the connection in Termius. Now go to BNC Viewer app. Select the plus sign to create a direct connection to the computer. Enter the address localhost, session number, as output, which is displayed in the Termius app. Type the name as Kali. Press done. Press connect. Press OK to continue. It will ask for the password, which is change me. Enable, remember password. Press continue. And Kali Linux at your screen. This is just a basic version of Kali image, which will not contain any pre-installed tools, but you can install the Kali tools, using the terminal of Kali Linux. The basic version of Kali Linux image is suitable to check the compatibility of Kali Linux in Android. To close the Kali Linux, just press the X symbol in the upper right corner. Press disconnect. To close the Termius app, just open it, and it will automatically close the connection. To close the Linux deploy process, just press the stop button and it will stop the process container. Swipe right. And press exit to close the Linux deploy app. If you like this video, please hit a like and subscribe to my channel.